Alright, here is my favorite part. That's where I get to show you what's inside. So let's open this up. First, you start by taking this little thing off here. You basically have to pry it off. It's just rubber. Here we go. You see that? It comes right off. Then you remove all these screws. And then this part just comes right off. Next, what you have to do is remove these guys here. Screws. And then you take these screws off to take out this and also the sides. Next, you flip it on the other side. This side. Alright, so here's where we remove the two connectors for the battery. At this point, we disconnect these cables, and then we remove these screws, and we remove that cover. There's two connectors, and just like that, they come off. This one I'm gonna leave on. Okay, next we're gonna remove these four screws. Here we go, remove this little connector. I'll mark this, black and white. Because it's not marked, which. There we go. Here's the other side. I'm gonna disconnect these fans. Okay, here we go. So now we can take these off. Battery plus, battery minus. So then we take these screws off. There's four screws on each posts here. And here we go. You just liberated the whole unit. And now we are left with the battery. We don't need to take this further apart because it's just a bunch of metal and plastic. So let's take this battery apart. Here we go. We just lift that. All right, here we go. Here is the battery. This is the best part of this teardown. There's 10 cells across and 7 cells forwards, which means that this is a 10S 7P block, and there's two of them. So as you can see here in the back, pretty interesting, the use of PCB to connect the one block to the other block, which makes this a 14S, right? 14 cells in series, 10 cells in parallel, right? So yeah, this would make it a 48 volt. Now let's look at the cells here. What are they? They're kind of nondescript Chinese cells. All that we can read is GPHN18-25P. I googled that and there is not much info on those cells. So they're just Chinese cells, probably 3000 milliamp hours or 3200 milliamp hours, because this is about 1.2 or 1.3 kilowatt hours. I think that's what the manufacturer claims to be. But of course, after our test, accounting with the inefficiencies of transformation from DC to AC power, then you are able to get 1 kilowatt hour, right? So other than that, this is a pretty simple design, but pretty clever. It's got these little handles here that allowed you to grab it and install it into the thing. And then after that is just the BMS. The BMS is quite big and beefy, and it's got quite a bit of thermistors. Look at that. So there's two of them here, two more over here, and then there's the one here that it's right on the MOSFETs there, right? And so that is the battery. All right, next on the list here is the inverter. This is what an inverter would look like if I would have to make a 2000 watt custom inverter, right? It differs a bit from the other ones that are commercially available because just in the setup, right? As far as the components, yeah, they're probably about the same. It's not got nice beefy inductors in here and transformers. It's got nice thick silicon cable here to be able to handle the 1800 watt continuous, and it's got very good airflow design by having two fans on each side, which allows efficient movement of air through these aluminum heat sinks here, right? And that whole row of MOSFETs. And here we go, a transformer. And of course, it's got these little baffles here to be able to keep the airflow right where you need it. And then here is the other board, which is the low voltage DC to DC section, right? What you have in here is the solar charge controller, which essentially is just essentially a charger, right? That goes from up to 65 volts down to 48 volts, right? And then here on this side is a 48 volts to 12 volts, right? To be able to power that car, the 12 volt port, right? And so that's what this board is, separate from that one. That one is just to make 48 volts into 120 volts AC, right? And then this is the DC to DC section. This is very well laid out in a different board that goes on top of that one. And then of course we have the four fans here that handle the airflow to keep this unit cool. On the rest of the parts, you just find very well and thoughtful design here. It's nice and compact. Here they end up using a PCB to run the AC side of things, so it's pretty crazy, right? This PCB will actually can handle close to 2000 watts continuous, right? And then this is the 12 volt port. It's got all this glue in here so it doesn't rattle off. And then the on-off switch here. On the other side here, well, it's pretty much the same thing. We have a nice layout with one big PCB board here that is going to handle all the DC to DC. This is the really low voltage setup with all the USB ports in here. And then, of course, the screen so that they give you information, right? So very, very nice layout, which allows this unit to be very, very compact. Now it's time to put this unit back together. This is how you test if it's well designed. So first we start with the battery. All right, after putting it together, let's see if it passes a test. Look at that, it turns on. How about this guy? It turns on this guy. How about the AC side? Fans are turning on. I think we got a nice working unit here. This is very good design. Very, very, very well designed. You can take it apart, you can service it, then you can put it back together in a few minutes. All you need is essentially one screwdriver. And I'm very, very impressed with this unit, and I'm glad that someone out there is making good quality products like this one, right? Remember, this is part of my in-depth review of the Delta 1300 that is going to post on my video. I will be giving away one of these units on that review video, so stay tuned for that. That's coming up pretty soon. I want to thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye.